I absolutely love my infusion company. They are very thorough and work quickly to resolve any issues. Every week, the company mixes up my IV nutrition called TPN and ships it out to me. However, my infusion company recently had a massive influx of new patients. Since I live about 6 hours away from the infusion company, they decided to switch me to a different pharmacy, which is closer to me. The new company is 5 hours away from my home. It broke my heart, and I cried when I heard I was being forced to change companies. The new pharmacy is actually an old acquaintance. I have been serviced by them before. My last encounter with them was an utter disaster. I was hoping this time things might be different, but so far, many of the same issues continue to arise. The new company had 3 weeks to set everything up. However, the intake person at the infusion company did not work on my case until the day before I needed my TPN. She sent orders over to my doctor's office and told the clinic she needed them back before the end of the day. My poor doctor's office was left scrambling trying to get my orders filled out and signed by my doctor. The receptionist from the medical clinic arranged for me to have a telemedicine appointment during the doctor's lunch break. My physician and I were able to work together to get all the needed information filled out on the forms. By the end of the day, all the paperwork was submitted to the infusion company. My TPN runs out on Thursdays. This means I need to receive my shipment on Thursdays to have a continuous supply of TPN. The pharmacist at the new company calls me late on Wednesday. She tells me she will send out the TPN tomorrow. It will be delivered on Friday. I am upset. I will have to live one day without TPN. On Friday, I receive the shipment. As I go through the delivery, I read the documents inside. On the doctor's orders, it lists four diagnosis codes: Pseudomonas, unspecified bacterial pneumonia, pneumonia due to other aerobic bacteria, and pneumonia due to Pseudomonas. I am immediately concerned. Why do my orders state I have pneumonia? I do not have pneumonia. I have pancreatitis. Instantly, I am stressed out. My insurance company will reject the claim for my TPN since IV nutrition is not a treatment for pneumonia. As I continue reading the paperwork, the insurance liability form states I will have to pay 20% of the cost for the TPN and supplies. I am nearly in tears. This amounts to almost $200 a day. I cannot afford that. In a panic, I call the infusion company. I talk to the receptionist. I ask for clarification on my financial responsibility. I walk her through the paperwork I was sent. The woman tells me, yes, the paperwork is not very clear. I owe 20% of the cost, but since I have secondary insurance, my secondary insurance should pay for the 20%. I ask, why isn't this information clearly stated on my paperwork? The receptionist admits the information is not very well outlined on the form. I then inquire about the diagnosis codes listed on my doctor's orders. I tell her I have pancreatitis. I do not have pneumonia. How do I get the diagnosis codes changed? The receptionist says when I was last on service with the pharmacy, these were my diagnosis codes. But now I have three additional diagnoses: gastrostomy complication unspecified, acute pancreatitis without necrosis or infection, and unspecified protein calorie malnutrition. The additional diagnoses are numbered 5, 6, and 7. All the codes are listed on her paperwork, but only the first four diagnosis codes are listed on the paperwork I was sent. After receiving this clarification, I thank the woman for the information. The phone call ends. This has been my experience so far with my new infusion company. I hope things go better in the weeks to come. I know God works all things for good. I know that through this trial, there will be a positive outcome. Thank you so much for joining me. Please remember to like and subscribe down below. I hope you have a great day and a wonderful week. Bye-bye.